Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I will discuss about the feedback circuit of the Smps. Now you know everything, that is not new for you, but that is a new part. What happened when we put this feedback and why we put this feedback? Because suppose you get here 12 volt and put the feedback through this line, that is your ground line, that is your supply line, that is positive and that is not negative, you know that. When you get 12 volt, you need this, then what is the activity of this device? First of all, you have to know what is the device actually, that is a optocoupler, and also you know that is your primary section. That is your primary section, and that is your secondary section, that is absolutely insulated. There is no DC coupled at all. So here is a ground, here is a ground that is not exactly directly connected with this ground. That is also a ground pin. I have to design this. That is a different ground. You should know that is a different ground. You cannot attach both in same ground. You have to know that first. Now you have to understand what is the feedback, what does feedback do. That is the important part of this lesson. Now see, when you go to do this, then you have to learn one thing, that is called PWM. That is your feedback control. And that is optocoupler, I already told you. And optocoupler primary part and secondary part, that is your primary part, that is a transistor, collector and emitter, and that is a diode. I mean that is the LED, light emitting diode. When voltage comes through this path, LED will on and transistor is connected to collector to emitter, so there is a short circuit. So if you put some voltage here and this voltage goes to through this transistor back to the ground, what happened when we put this circuit? Actually the feedback circuit control that is your feedback control, that control your PWM. I don't know you know anything about PWM. I just tell you little bit because it is important. If you don't know that, I will make a next video for what is PWM, how it is working. But now I just discuss about the working procedure. That is your first frequency. You have to see that is your first frequency. Suppose that is a 50%, that is a 50%. So your frequency start from here, your pulse, no, actually that is not pulse, that is actually cycle start from here and stop here, that is off period, and that is on period. The 50% time is your on period and 50% time is your off period. When you and look at this signal oscillator IC, this IC can generate the signal and that is also called signal generator. When you put this pulse to MOSFET into gate of this MOSFET, so your switching already started, so you get voltage from here. How it is working I already told you in my before video. But when you give the feedback from the output of this of your SMPS, then it is effect on the feedback control pin. That is your feedback control pin. Actually feedback control do nothing, just change the duration of this pulse. That is 50%, that is 50%. But when PWM is working, then it is suppose 20% and it is suppose 80%. So your pulse duration 80% is off, 20% is on. So when you put this pulse, when you put this pulse, your transformer charging time goes to be short. It make a EMF, make a energy, store a energy in that transformer. But when you change this pulse, I mean off period and on period, then your transformer energized lower power, or different thing is low level energy stored in this transformer. So when it is off, that is your off period, when it is off, then it collapses and secondary get voltage. So this voltage goes to be lower than this pulse. This pulse can generate more power, this pulse generate low power. That is the basic idea of PWM. That is the automatically circuit. First of all, you have to understand that when you get greater voltage, more than 12 volt, I already told you that is your 12 volt output, you get 15 volt, then the optocoupler is on. That is a zener diode. One more thing I have to discuss about zener diode. I think you know, if not, I tell you. If your multimeter in DC voltage, put positive probe here and negative probe here, if this zener diode is 12 volt, then your meter, multimeter can show, will be show, not can show, will be show 12 volt. If here is a 12 volt or more, that means the difference between these two point always the zener diode voltage. I think you understand that. If your 12 volt zener diode, then the difference must be 12. That means your meter show 12 volt from this to this path. If it is 6, then you get 6 volt. If it is 8, then get 8 volt. That is the basic of zener diode. And also you know that every diode is a zener diode. You have to know that first. If 1N4007, that is the breakdown voltage is 100. So that is a 100, that is a breakdown voltage is 1000. That is the 1000 volt zener diode. if this voltage is, say suppose I cannot remember this AP 200 or 600 or some other value also there, each and every 200, 600 means that is the breakdown voltage, that is the after 200 volt you can get 1 volt. I think if you put here a opposite diode, say I cannot remember this number just now, some 200, AP 200, something like that. So that is a Zener diode. Each and every diode is a Zener diode, working as a Zener diode, don't forget it. Now come to the point, if you get 12 volt, this circuit is off. Why? Because this voltage is zero. This point is zero. Because 12 volt fully raised through this diode, so here come 0 volt. So LED not working and transistor also not. So your signal generator cannot get any feedback voltage. So your PWM working like that. That is your pulse, and you get a normal voltage if it is high. How it is? If your input voltage more than 310, suppose 350, then you get more voltage here, because that is turn ratio, you know that is your primary turn, that is your secondary turn. So primary turn and secondary turn ratio always same, you cannot change it. So you get a high voltage here. This feedback circuit do one thing, go back to this path, control the optocoupler and change the PWM, and you get again 12 volt, but the frequency on time and on off time should be changed to control this circuit and voltage also. And I have to tell you something, each and every device has a power supply board pin, each and every device, you know that. Here is the pin 1 is a power supply pin. You control this voltage, right? See that when it is on, this voltage goes to this path, I already told you. So here is a voltage. When IC will work, then ground and power should be there, otherwise it cannot work. Here is a resistance network. Do you know what is the actual meaning of resistance network? That is the voltage divider. You need 12 volt DC, but here is the voltage is 310 volt DC. How can we get this voltage? That is the way to get this voltage. That is the one of the way, not all. And here is a 12 volt Zener, like as this. It is confirmed that this voltage is 12 and your IC is protected. It never goes to high, something like that. I already told you, if there is 350 volt, you get high voltage here. If there is 350 volt, you also get high voltage here. Absolutely. Nobody can protect this except this diode. Don't worry, if you put a Zener diode here, you get a Zener diode voltage here. If it is 12 volt Zener diode, you can get here 12 volt. If it is 15 volt Zener diode, then you get here 15 volt. because other upper voltage through this diode goes to ground. And if you tell me, then why you put this resistance network here? No boss, that is not. Because all voltage, if I don't put this, all voltage through this Zener diode and make it 12 volt. Not only that, it will be burned out. This resistance protect the ampere. And this resistance stable the voltage. And also you know each and every device have a ampere capacity. That is not a line voltage, that is not depend on line voltage. That is ampere always driven by the component. Always remember that. If you put 9000 ampere here, don't worry. This signal generator never draw this current because each and every device have a resistance. So it cannot draw this current from the main line. Current draw by the device, voltage will given to device. So if you not change this voltage, this device cannot draw more current if it is not short circuit. Now you think if there is a problem, if you don't understand, please tell me in my comment box. Or it is helpful, then please do this. You know what to do. Thank you. Thank you very much.